Okay, hi, my name is Tobias Morgan. I'm going to do a hopefully in-depth enough review, talking to you, of these soft panel that we just got today from Kickstarter. That's only a year late. Hopefully it was worth the wait. But I'm texting right now with a friend who also got a set of two who did not, who also had some downfalls where his power supply unit over here came in actual pieces, where the one end was off and the wires were hanging all over the place. But what I'm going to try and go over is the build quality, the color temperature, how accurate they are, the brightness, lux wise at each color temperature, not each but 20 32 4000 and 5500 K, the battery life and the battery versus plug it in. Is there a difference in the intensity of the light, along with the auto color feature, which these have, a color feature where you push a button on the back of the unit, which is right here. Okay, auto color. And then it shuts off the light. It takes a reading of the actual ambient light that's in the room, and then it sets the color temperature to that color temperature that's in the room. Time-wise, to do that took about 5 to 8 seconds where it shut off. And if it matters, you know, some people don't matter. Some people in some situations, time matters for everything. So, but let's get started with the review. Okay, first, color temperature. First thing that I want to go over too, I purchased a two-pack from Kickstarter. With the two-pack, one that I got, this one right here, has some damage on the back of it. Right here, I'm not sure if you can see that little thing in there. On the back here, also, there was a couple little tiny things which annoyed me somewhat, that if I'm purchasing new lights, they should be new. Also, I'm being lit right here by the other 1x2. Back here, I have a little kicker light on me, which is a Kane TV bicolor 1048, I think it is, 1048 lights in it, which has been my tried and true one that I use on every wedding and every video shoot that I usually go to when I need big lights. When I need little ones, I have little Drake cast, little Lola lights, whatever. Okay, first now, let's go and read color temperature. Now, this one right here that we're on is set at exactly 3200K. Okay, what does that say right there? Can we see it? 3470. Let's bring the light out here. And what does it say right there? Let's do a little zoom. Go back in there. Focus. Come on. Focus. But anyway, let's do it the hard way. You can't even do it manually. I'm on a Sony 63 and 6500. Come on, how about now? There. Basically 3200K, 71% intensity. All right, so let's put that back there. Let's change it now to 4000K. And the funny thing about this, here, let's go here, about this one, was that this knobs here and here have clicks. And my other one, the other unit, has no clicks at all. All right, we're at 4,000, 71%. Let's move the light back. There. get me back here. Let's test it here. What does it say right there? 4320. Okay. I don't have the newer, light meter, which would tell me the actual color quality and the fidelity of the light. But, I found similar results with this one right here, where actually let's do it again here. So 44,000, let's go to 5,500K. Trust me, it's on it. So 5,500K is 5550, or actually that one is fairly accurate. So it's not that it's off by a specific amount across the spectrum. Now let's test it at, that's at 71%. Let's go at 100% now, which is very bright. Okay, 5,500K, 5,530, 5,540. So it is consistent with the how much it's off. 30 degrees is not a lot. So that's a beautiful thing. Let's go back to 4,000. Now, still at 100%. Check it out. 4310. So it is consistent with how much it's actually off. So let's go back to 3200 now. Okay, we're at 3200K at 100%. What do we got? 3560. Let's go right up to it. What do we got? 3470. So I can't understand how it can possibly be off like that when it has a light meter built in. Let's go now down to 50% intensity. And for it's at 50% at 3200K, I'm going to shut off these now so we have no contamination. I'm going to also shut off the overhead lights, so we have no light. The only light in this room is this coming from this right here. So this is supposed to be at 3200K, 3460. Where are we at? I don't know if we can see it there. Okay, 3460 at 50%. And let's go down to 4,000. 4,000, okay, hold on, 4,000, we are at 4,300 exactly, okay, there, can we see it, there, okay, now, let's go back up to 5,500, Okay, so now we're at 5,500K and 5,710, 5,600, 5,640, let's go right up, 5,680, 5,680. So not terribly off, 100, 200 degrees, but still, if you have a light meter built in or color meter built in, it should actually be, I would assume, more accurate. That's what they were boasting. So boldly. All right, now let's turn on the room lights where they are. Let's go up, let's see if we can see it right here. Can we get higher there? All right, now that is 3030, 3080. Let's take a regular ambient room light. 3090, so basically about 3100 degrees. Now let's do this and let's push the auto button on me. Now let's zoom out. All Okay, now you push the auto button. Waiting for it to register. Okay, so now we got color temperature 3120. So it's fairly accurate to what the room was, but let's see what the actual temperature on the back of the unit says. 2890 is what it says. Okay, 2890, 50%. So what it's telling you is not what it actually is. The numbers, maybe the unit hasn't been calibrated. So we got 3120, which is close to what's up there, 3080, 3100, but the actual numbers that it's saying, what it's supposed to be, is not what it's actually outputting. 2890 compared to 3120. Not accurate, not giving you the proper information. So you may be setting your camera at 2890, which is technically 200 degrees off from what it actually is. Now, it's supposed to have this auto skin tone feature where I was told, hold on 1 second. Okay, we got a fresh battery and we're back. Next test we're gonna do is the auto skin tone enhancer feature on it. We're still at 3070, 3090, 3070. Okay, now I have the camera right here. It's a Sony A6300 or 6500, this may be. Actually, 6500. It's set on auto white balance. I'm going to, actually, we're gonna go and put it into 3100. Hold on, I gotta stop the video. Okay, now, I set this camera, we're gonna test the skin enhance feature. I set this camera over here at 3100K specifically. It's not in auto white balance. This light is at 3100. The skin enhance button I'm going to press, it's daylight, or not daylight balance, it's balance for the light in the room. So these are 3100. This adjusted to 3100. Now I'm pushing the skin enhance button to see what difference it actually changes. We'll see that I pushed it. I didn't see nothing happen. Skin, I'm pushing it again. Let's take another reading, see what we got. 3000, 3030, 3040. 3040. I don't know if you've seen any difference. I'm going to change the lights out because on my first unit, this one right here, I pushed the skin enhance button and it went down by 1000 degrees in the daylight. Okay, that's why I waited to do this review till it's nighttime out. Shut this light off now. We're going to go back to this one and see if it's, hold on, let me unplug it. And we're going to test it. Find the plug and light this one from this side. Here we go, turn it on. Now, one thing you'll notice about each of these, takes like 5-6 seconds for it to actually boot up. These do not have, or this one, should I say in specific, does not have any clicking. Put the mic next to it. Okay, no clicking, just a smooth dial. And one thing that I did not like, you put it on zero, and I'm still going down. Okay, zero. Okay, before it was jumping up to 5, 6, 7%. Okay, let's go down to 2700. I'm turning, but it's not. Okay, the lowest it goes is 2700. There, now I got it to 2700. Okay, and I'm turning it, but why is it going up, not down? Okay, let's go nice and slow to get it there. Let's do back to our auto white. See what we get. Remember, the other light says 3100. 2960 is the number it gave us, but that was a similar number like the other one. Let's measure this one. Okay, now this one also, okay, we're at 22%. Come on. Damn cord. My iPhone is brighter than that. Okay. So it's not very bright. It's technically on a shoot. It's not bright enough to you reach at least 50% to get anything that's substantial out of this. If you're working in a dark room and you want to do macro or micro photography or videography, then maybe it's great that it can go down to that low. But for 99% of anything that we shoot, we need high intensities. Okay, and you're not getting that out of this until you reach above 50%. All right, so now let's do the skin tone enhance. Let's put it up to 50% now. Okay, put it, don't mind my mess here. Okay, I got junk everywhere, cables going across the floor. All right, so now here we are, skin tone. Let's zoom in a little bit, get a better look. Okay, that's normal, that's what the room is. Now we're set at 3100. Oh, let's check the color temperature of this one. 3110. Okay, can you see it? I got the meters is blocking it. Okay, 3110. Now let's push the skin enhance right here. Okay, skin 2870. Let's see what happens. How does it look? From what I'm looking on my monitor, it looks okay. Let's see what we get. 2970. So it did actually go down 200. But why? I should have recorded it this afternoon. In daylight, it went down literally 1,000 degrees. So I don't know if I didn't video it. I didn't test it. Just I checked it out with the back of the screen on the little LCD. And it said 1,000 degrees less than what it was. Okay, so now let's see. My friend is texting me that he's got his and he's having his own little technical difficulties. He also did say, okay, for the case wise, for those of you who have the Ronin, the full size Ronin, that it fit like a glove in the Ronin case. So I still have to test that. I have my Ronin in the garage. Okay. It's a picture that it fits like a glove inside the Ronin case. Okay, so, and he just took the yokes off, not the yokes off, he took the power supply off of the unit. Oh, and he also wanted me to tell you guys about that. Let me turn this one back on so we can light it up. About this, the, panel, face panel on the front of the power supply, that it makes a noise. So it's there. I don't mind it. I think it's actually a nice little advertising display sign that you can actually put up and put your company logo or name, print something out on a printer and slide it in there, glue it to the face of there, and you know, put Tobias Morgan Creatives, my company name, on there. Okay, so now we went over the color temperature. We're gonna go over what we got next here on my list. Okay, color temperature, brightness. Brightness at each different color temperature and what lux it was. I had asked Kevin this question back last year when we had first ordered them from him on Kickstarter. And my wife's giving me a dirty look. Ordered them on Kickstarter, and he says 27, 28, and 2900. I didn't ask him how many feet, which was my bad, but I'm assuming at 3 feet is usually what they're normally measured at. So 2700 lux at 3200K, 2800 at 4000K and 2900 lux at 5500K. So I have that set up here, and I got my tape measure set up right there at 36 inches. I'm going to put the light meter right in front of it so we can measure, and I will tell you the actual lux. Let's turn this one away so we're not getting any kind of contamination, and we're going to go up to 100%. Now, also one thing that I just realized, okay, I'm stuck in skin tone mode, so let me, okay, dial it. Once you dial it, now you can get it back to whatever. So let's go in back here to 3200. Let's go all the way up to 100%, which is a pain. It's not something that can be done quickly. All right, 100%. It's bright. And let's do our, turn on my Siconic L478DR. Can't even see it, and it's my little light meter. All right, so now we're at 3 feet from the light, and we're putting it right in front, 2400 lux. Okay, let's do it again. Okay, so let's turn this one up a little bit so we got a little more light on me. And okay, we got on this light, there we go, 2200 lux is what it's telling me, 2400. Let's test it now. Turn this one down again. And what's screwed up, I'll show you that in a second. I'm turning the knob, okay, to turn the volume, the intensity down. And I'm flipping it because I want to go quick. And it's staying at 70%, 70%. It's fluctuating all over the place, but it's not really going down. Okay, so is it Chinese components? I don't know. You make that decision. All right, so now we're gonna take this. We're gonna go into 3200K. We're going up. Can we see that? 4000K. Let's bring it back. All right, so now 4000K, let's turn it off axis so we don't get, it's also intensity still at 100%. Let's turn this one off for a second. So we got just this light, so we're not getting extra light. We don't want to falsely read it. Okay, we got 2600, 26, 26, 27, 26, 26, 26. So this one's telling me we got 2600K at 4000K color temperature. Let's do another one while we're waiting. While we're waiting for something to happen, life to go on. All right, 5500 exactly we're at. There, 100%. All right, let's see here. Let's go back. And here we go. 3,000 lux. 3,000 lux. 3,000. 3,000. So that one's at 3,000 lux at 5,500K. Now, let's go all the way because the lights go up to 7,200K. Nice and blue, as you can see from the video. So at 7,200K, we are getting still 3,000 lux. Oh, I got a 3,200. 3,200 we got it up to. All right, so you got 3,200 lux at 7,200K, 3,000 lux at 5,500K. I don't know who shoots at 7,200 lux or 7,200K or whatever, unless you're outside in the shade. But let's put it back down to 3,100, what it should be. Still, I'm still dialing. 68, 66, 66, 68, 67. I'm going down only. 70, 66, 66, 64. Now let's do it nice and slow. Okay, like I'm 100 years old. Now we got it going down. Okay. So to me, that's telling me that it's cheap components that you use to build it. Okay, so we're at 3,100 even. Okay. Back to 3,100K. Okay, now we're gonna shut this off and the next test we're gonna do is battery life, okay? And you don't need to go take a coffee break for this one because it's something that's gonna be significant on the choice of using these lights. Now, in their defense, Mitch on Kickstarter, shut it off, hold on, too bright. Okay, but Mitch on Kickstarter, let's put this one back on. There we go. Mitch on Kickstarter did say something that I only been doing video for like 4 or 5 years. I've been doing photo for 29 years now. Said that you have to do, I think, HC, high capacity, V-mount batteries. These are V-mount units because I have like 4 or 5 V-mount batteries that I use for my Kame TV ones, which will last me. I don't even have to put them at like 50% on a wedding. I'm using them at between 25 and 50% if I need to, if it's a huge room, and they'll last me 2 weddings. Okay, on a cheap little like 98, 99 milliamp battery. I don't know if it's exactly the milliamp, but it's 99 is the number on the battery. I have 2 big, huge ones that I just purchased. That's 177 from Amazon. I'll show you them in a second. But anyway, now another thing I want to go over before we go to the battery test is the intensity, okay? Because I'm going to turn this one so we got nice low light, okay, at 50%. This one is at 50% right now, and with that backlight, it's not lighting me at all. Okay, so actually, you know what? Even better. I'm gonna shut this one off completely. So there's no light. The only light that you're gonna be seeing in this room is from overhead. Okay. Okay. Now, I'm only lit from overhead, the room lights in this room. Okay, let's, I'm done, did I shut this one off? Yes, no, I didn't. Okay, now, this one I'm gonna turn on. I turned it on during the day. I did not even see light until I was at 28% of the power. Now, we're gonna leave it at 3,100 so it's at the right color temperature. I'm gonna put this other camera. We got this one now. at 0%. All right, now we are at 1%, 2%. Okay, but this, I'm looking at this one right here, and it looks just as bright as this one. This one's not on at all. Okay, now let's go. Okay, I'm being lit more by what's up top. Okay, now we are at 16% of this light. Okay, do I barely look like I'm lit on it? If it's a dark room and you want a little kicker light, then yes, but let's go even higher now. ...25% brightness. And believe me, it's not bright at all. I'm going to adjust the exposure here so you see what it actually looks like. Okay, brightness wise. That is, you can't tell because the exposure, but it's barely lit up. Let me, hold on, we're gonna go and go back to minus, I'm at minus two stops right now for the camera. All right, let's now, hold on. Okay, 25%. I'm gonna put my Kane TV on. Okay, that's at 3200. That's at 10%, the lowest it can go. Okay, look at the difference between this light and this light behind me. Okay, this looks like it's nothing. Okay, so at 10% from the Kane TV, that's 30% now. Still, the Kane TV looks brighter than the soft panels. 50%. Now we're starting to get, like I said, some decent amount of light out of it. Okay? The soft panels and the Kane TV, they look about the same intensity right now. Okay? But one's at 10%. And one's at 50%. So now let's go up to 60%. Okay. Now it's starting to look brighter than this. Now let's go and, well, we don't really need to do any more. Let's go to 100%. Okay. Now it's overpowering for sure the Kane TV. But I'm gonna do a quick lux test on the Kane TV one to see what the intensity is at 10% and what the intensity is at 100%. So let's first shut the Kane TV off because I wanna do a quick test on this one, on the soft panels at 10%. Still look okay. How many times am I turning it? We're barely getting there. Taking only like an hour. Okay. 10%. We're gonna shut off the overhead lights. Find my tape measure. Okay. Let's go out to 3 feet. Who's calling me? My buddy's calling me. All right. We don't got time. All right, 10%, 3 feet. And let's turn it back on, booting up. Come on, turn it back on, booting up. Okay, 3200 lux. We are at 2.5 lux. At 3 feet at 10%, okay? It's not even that it's like on 1%, it's on 10%, okay? Let's go up to 25% and let's see what we got now. At 25%, we're at 14 lux. Okay, 14 lux. Now let's go up to 50%. This is at 3,100K. 3,100? Yes, 3,100K we're set at. So remember, the numbers were lower at 3,100K. Let's go to 50% we're at. So let's do another test here. We are at 120 lux. So all the magic on this light happens between 50% and 100% of the intensity of it. Okay, now let's shut this one off. And we're gonna do our KAME TV lights, okay? Now we're at 10%. Get the camera up here. Zoom in on the KAME TV. Where are we? Right there. All right. KAME TV is at 10%, 3,200K. Let's do our test now. Right up to the light, 3 feet. 10% is 280 lux. Okay, 10%. Now, at 3,200K. Now, just for you guys who wanted to know, color temperature of the KAME TVs, they were off. Where's the light meter? I mean, the color meter is in my pocket, of course. Okay. KAME TV color temperature at 3,200K is, come on, 3510. 3510. And I have a, I think a quarter CTO gel in there to bring it down because it was like 800 degrees off. So I'm not saying that they're the best lights. I'm just saying that for the price, it's not bad. All right, let's go to 25%. Okay, now that light is at 25%, 3,200K. Let's test this one. And we are at, come on, 700 lux. Okay, for 25%. Let's go to 50%. Okay, these numbers actually, they respond when you're turning these knobs. Maybe I should take the KAME TV knobs and put them into the soft panels. All right, so now 50%, 1100 lux, 1100 lux. Okay, let's do color temperature also while we're waiting here. Still 3510. 3560, 3490, 3500. So it's around 3500. All right, now let's go up to 100% on KAME TV. 3 feet. 1700 lux. Okay.
Okay, now we're going to check the lux. Now we're going to check the lux on the different color temperatures on the KAME TV. Okay, 3200 we just did. Now we're gonna go to 4000 lux. Okay, I think that's actually higher than what the soft panels were. Now let's go to the 5500, 5600 actually. 5600K, we are at 1900 lux. Okay, 5600K. Color temperature wise, 5990, 5870, 5900, 5890. So it's still off by 300 degrees. Let's check the 4000K. But like I said before, I have the quarter CTO in here to warm it up even more. 4000K is 4300. Okay, so I picked that because that's seems to be the one that has the most neutral, because as you go throughout the spectrum, it changes the color temperature. Could be lighter or darker. All right, now we're going to get into this battery situation that you're going to love. This one, the battery that I'm using is a, shut off the Came TV, let's put on this one back to 3100 that I still got the camera set on. Okay, the battery that I'm using is a, can we see it? Let's zoom in a little bit. Okay, it's a 99, I wanna say milliamp, milliwatt hour, or 99 whatever. It's the largest capacity that you can bring with you on a plane that's legal. So we're gonna put it on the back of this soft panels. We're gonna turn it on and we're gonna put it at 100%. And you can start your stopwatch now because 100%, 3100K. And I'm going to shut off these lights and we can sit and we can watch and wait and see how long it takes. Right now it is 49 degrees in Roseland, New Jersey. Okay, 8:46 and 30 seconds. So the reason why I'm doing this test and showing you guys, because they also said in, like I said before, on the Kickstarter that you're going to need high capacity batteries is one thing that they recommended. That normal, this is just a regular V-mount battery. I do have other batteries that we can do another test, but regular batteries, you can't even really use them on here if you're going to put it at full power. So, but the reason I'm doing this, because I just threw this on just to see the quality of my battery, because initially we all had that problem where they were saying that they had to go back and redo the power circuit board because there was issues with the power drain. I don't know if they fixed it or they just said the hell with it, we're already so far behind, let's just get them out. But I went downstairs to go get this tape measure, and when I came back up, the light was off. So I was like, what's going on? What happened? So, and then I did a test and seeing that it actually just doesn't last long at all with this. So let's sit here and watch. On the back of the thing here, it's saying 1 bar, and on the battery itself has 1 bar, but when I put it in, it had 4 out of 5 bars. So let's see if we get any kind of signal here telling us that it's going to go down on us. Now it's turning red. The little battery. Let's go in close. Mr. DeMille's. Let's wait, see how long. This one's not too bad. We're actually getting, it's almost 3 minutes out of it so far. Yeah, that one bar just disappeared. Now we just got red. Now it went off. What the hell was that? That wasn't good. Now also, I'm going to shut the power off. On my battery, I can click it and look. Hold on, let me turn on this other light so we got something going on, see what we're doing. On this other, get it into the frame, the power indicator, where's it at? There. Okay, it's not lighting. So you can't even turn the light on and off. You have to take the battery off. But where are we at? Okay, now we still got 4 bars of battery. So it's not handling the drain on the battery is the problem. So let's go and get one of my high capacity batteries. Okay, Eco Special, super duper size. Let's compare this one compared to okay, here's the one we had on there. Let's zoom out a little bit. Here's what we had on there. Here's the other one. Okay, difference in size. Okay, let's put this one on and see what kind of life. Really? There, okay. Is it on? Before I put it on, show you. All 4 bars, blue. There we go. Power. Soft panels, bring it in. For our close-up, auto color, 50%. This is fully charged. I just charged it. We got 4 out of the 5 bars at 50%. Let's go to 100%. Now we got all 5 bars are lit. Now it just dropped down to 4. Now it just dropped down to 3. And this is 177. It says 11,000 milliamp hours, 162 on the battery. Let's see if we can get it over here. Okay, that's the battery we're using. It's actually a green battery. It was an awesome deal at Adorama. I think I paid $128 each. It was sick, so I bought 2 of them. But let's see how it handles on this, rather than paying $300, $400, $500 for a battery. So seems to be holding its own somewhat. But we'll find out on a real job. I'm not gonna sit here for another hour or two to see how long it's gonna last. So let's do a test. If we go down to 50%. Yeah, 50% and the battery meter is going up. So, but like before, 50% doesn't really do much for us. Where is it? Okay, but quality of light seems to be not bad. It's nice. The size of the light is nice. The quality of the light is nice. Is it worth, well, we paid on Kickstarter $1,050 each. It was like $2,135 with shipping for 2-pack. I think the normal price is supposed to be like $1,600. I don't know. You make that decision if you think that it's worth it. I think that they have to work the bugs out. I think sometimes it's worth waiting for the, not the prototypes that we're getting, but going for the, trying to turn the intensity down here because I see my face is blown out. Sometimes I think it's worth not going for the prototypes or the first run on a Kickstarter project because now you're dealing with stuff like this that comes in broken, comes in with substandard parts and not good quality. So, but that's just me. I like to purchase things that I know I'm going to not use that word in my vocabulary, regret. I'd rather spend the money because I'm learning as I've been doing this for the last 5 years that I'll try and save some money and buy something cheaper. And in the long run, I ended up just throwing that aside and buying the better stuff because it's going to work and it's going to make your job a lot easier in the end. So, all right. Hope that was a good review. And I hope it helped everybody who's thinking of buying the I hope it helped everybody who's thinking of buying soft panels helped you educate you a little bit more making your educated decision. Thanks. Before we go, I forgot one last thing. I wanted to do a test on the battery power intensity, if that has any effect, if it has any effect on the output intensity compared to power plug output. All right, so here we're at. Let's go to 3100K again. Let's go 200%. Come on, we got it. We're getting it. We're getting it. Eventually, we'll get there. Or I can just do it nice and slow and get there quicker. Slow is fast. Fast is slow. All right. Now, let's get my tape measure. Let's go back to power it on. 3 feet. Here we go. And 2400 lux. I think it's about the same as what we had previously with the 100% at 3100. Let's go up for a quick test. 4000. Okay. And do another one. Should be the same, because if one of them is the same, the other one should be the same. 36 inches right there. 3000 lux. And let's go up to the 56. 5600. Six right there. Three 3000 lux. Same thing. Try it again. 3200 lux. So, the decision to be made is it so much better than whatever else is on the market? And we just went over my new battery. Okay, even with the big killer battery, just died. Okay, so that just, now it's powering up again. So, battery saying 2 bars on it. This is saying 2 bars on it. So, basically, at 100%, I don't think it's going to work with any battery. You'd have to go and test and try and find out what battery will actually do the job for you. But I'm for portability, I'm disappointed.